This webcast may contain adult language or adult themes or adult content. So, there, you've been warned.
Welcome to Gay Nerd Love.
This is what we talk about when we're not doing it. I'm Andy.
I'm Archie, and we are coming to you from Portland, Oregon on our YouTube web series.
Yes, although today we are doing it and talking about it, right? So we're kind of mixing it up a bit.
Yes, we always try to bring something different to you on the show. And in this case...
We don't want you to get bored. We really don't. I mean, look at that picture right there. A lot's going on.
Yeah, what is that picture of? It's the show icon today.
It's frightening
today.
Me. It's really scaring me.
Well, you know, I can tell, you know, with Japanese. You can tell it's Japanese because...
These are the eggs we are about to fertilize is what it looks like. It looks like a cartoon is going to give birth or something.
Well, I see sushi. And I see some grinning character and lots of color.
Lots of stuff.
And lots of Japanese characters. So today, we in an earlier show, we tried to do this this Popin Cookin thing. It's a Japanese food kits where you can make edible food with powders and water.
Teeny tiny little food.
And that wasn't... I don't even remember that... how well that show went. Because
hardcore fans will remember what an embarrassment that episode was when we were doing it audio only.
But we have the remaining kits from when we did before, and I'm gonna go to our little display table set up right now.
And
yeah, so these are little food kits.
That's Archie.
Yes.
And this is Andy.
This is me. Hello, Archie. Hello. That's Andy.
Okay.
And so these Popin Cookin food kits, they're pretty interesting. So we're going to attempt to do them side by side, and we'll see how it goes. I mean, these kits are at least, 2 years old by now?
At least.
So I don't know if the camera...
Are these the ones you got in Seattle at your Wachamaya, or did you get these online?
These were online.
You could buy these online, by the way.
Buy them online, and you get a better deal if you buy them like in a group of five or six or something.
A pack,
and yeah, individually they're much more expensive. So yeah, these are like candy food, and it's supposed to represent. This is supposed to be a bento box with noodles and rice and stuff. So, oh, and by the way, all the instructions are in easy to understand Japanese.
Right. So the only way that I think this is actually a plot to just make Americans do silly things. So we're not going to disappoint our Japanese friends. We're going to show them just what we do when we can't read the instructions and have to go simply buy the pictures, right?
Yes, the pictures that are on the back here.
They're on the back with tiny, tiny little type.
Yes, insy weensy Einstein type. And we're both wearing glasses, by the way.
I'm old. But yes, that's... Trying to remember.
Yeah. There you go. Okay. So listen to the crackling noise.
Oh, we're going to get the ASMR effect here.
So I'm opening mine right now.
Yes.
And we'll toss the box.
It's orange.
Actually, I keep the box nearby so I know what
to... Oh, we need the box. That's definitely what we need.
I think the box...
I'm going to just put mine right here so I can see, like, the writing I can't understand.
So it's supposed to be completely, you know, self-contained. Like, this part is supposed to be the staging area where you make...
Yeah, nothing is wasted. Right. It's very environmental, as much as this possibly could be.
So
but, yeah, look.
It comes a little fork.
This has, like little, like, things you cut out and do stuff with.
And all these powders, packs of powders.
These look like sea monkey kits.
They do.
Don't they? Instant life. But yeah, this looks like you're supposed to like slowly and carefully uncut this and like turn it into like a little sushi stand or something.
I think so.
That's too much.
And then there's a bag of something you're supposed to make. So we'll see how best we can do with the indecipherable instructions and tiny pictures. Now we do know from past kits, right, honey, that this part is for water, isn't it?
Yes, I believe so.
Right. So,
and not only is it for water, but I think, yeah, because look, there's this little, right here, there's this little nip that you pour with. That's like the pouring, so it's like a little...
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Yes.
So, we have scissors.
Yeah, I don't even know if I'm putting these upside down or right side up, but I understood that the first thing you want to do is, like, See the things you have.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Okay.
Make sure you've got all your shit together.
Well, that's
what's the name of the guy who taste tests stuff online and makes fun of him?
Oh, Shane. Yeah.
Shane is very online. Funny at this stuff. We very much enjoy his particular take
especially
on
the faces
doing it
makes.
And then making the faces as he eats them. So we're not going to go that far today. We'll leave you. We will post links to his wonderful and enjoyable shenanigans, I guess is the best word. So is it you're supposed to trim the little measuring,
yes,
whatever?
Right.
So basically, this is the only tool you provide. Everything else is, and water. Everything else is pretty much part of the kit, right?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. So now we have the little water container.
Yeah.
Here.
All I can think of while I'm playing with this would make great detail for a spaceship, because right. That's what we used to build when we were kids.
And
right?
These are the compartments that build
the
different parts.
Yeah. I mean, look at this.
Parts.
It's like a space station.
So basically, these
we'll use these later.
These powders and these things are supposed to turn into that.
Believe it or not, we are going to attempt to make this. Okay.
All right. So
this is a comic webcast. All right. So yeah, the first thing it tells you is to cut that right there. It like the instructions in case you didn't get it. It's already helping you along.
Oh, what are we supposed to cut?
We already did it.
Oh, yes. Oh, right. There's a picture on here
that
tells you to cut
centimeter.
This little thing off. Tells you to cut this.
Is that what that means? Or does that mean we're supposed to cut the bag? I think that means we're supposed to cut the bag.
Oh, really? And
but
that
what
corner.
For? Probably not yet.
Probably
I'm getting ahead
probably
of
to make noodles. So
I'm going
to
look at this. So what do we do first? So
it
we
looks
cut the,
like
I,
we,
I,
green. It looks like green.
Okay. As you can see, the first step is like still indecipherable.
Yes, but it's a green. Fortunately, they color code the steps. So,
oh, okay. So we're
so
doing
we use
green.
The green packet.
Oh yes,
first.
Yes. I remember right. Now. It's all coming back to me. So the green is the first stuff that you want to use, and of course you want to, whatever that particular verb would be. So yeah, you changing this.
No, you did not. Now, which compartment does the green go into?
It goes in to... I can't see.
It looks like the little skull part. Yes, it goes
skull,
into the little
skull. The
skull?
Oh, my God. So this thing.
That's supposed to be broccoli.
I think. We're making broccoli. So
okay,
first we make broccoli. Okay, so would you just cut the little...
Yeah, cutting a corner
cut
off.
Cut a tiny corner off.
Then pour it into the broccoli slot.
The broccoli slot. That's my new punk band name. It opens for Pussy Riot on tour.
I'm pouring into the broccoli slot.
Go for it. I'm going to do it at a far angle. You do it at the close-up because you have better control.
Okay.
Okay.
Green
so, yeah, you notice
the
pretty much
slot.
the whole modus operandi with these kits is basically powder and water.
Just put all your powder right there. Powder pack is right there.
Oh, yeah,
on.
I'll put those over here where stuff goes to die.
Right.
Okay.
And then
the itty-bitty water thing?
Yes. My guess is the measurements are probably all the same,
well,
right?
I see it. You see the little number right there?
Right.
I think,
it tells you how many waters to put
one.
In.
I think
that
means one.
Okay,
yeah.
That's a good...
That'd be my guess.
All right. Okay, so one
so we
water.
Scoop a little? Yeah. Scoop it? Pour
yeah,
it?
I would say scoop it.
Scoop it. Oh, I can't scoop it. That doesn't look like
now,
one whole water, but it's almost one whole water.
Now these... I remember these powders being as...
It's getting greener.
They get... they sort of... It congeal and harden. As you add water to it, right?
Yes.
I'm gonna have to tilt.
I need a little more, because I can't.
And you can tilt the glass toward it.
You can't get the whole.
You can tilt the glass toward the thing, so you can.
That's what I did.
Oh, okay.
There. Okay. So then you use what? The top of the fork to stir it with?
Yes.
Is that what we're supposed to do? Because I don't see any stirrer.
So I'm stirring it.
Oh, I can feel the texture is already forming. Oh. Is there, like, more powder in here? Because this thing isn't going to fill up. Or did I just not put enough water in there? I'm going to put more water in there. Hopefully not. I can already smell the kind of fruity smell.
Oh yes, it all smells like fruit. Oh no, by the way, we neglected to mention that these things taste like the things.
No, of course they haven't perfected that technology yet. But this is edible stuff. Are there other Popin Cookin stuff that you make that looks good but doesn't eat good, that you don't eat, or that's just...
Oh, who would bother?
There's
a lot of work.
So there isn't.
There may be. I wouldn't want to.
Okay. See, now I put more water in here, and now it's even with the top now.
Oh, mine isn't.
Add more water. That
more
works.
Water. Okay.
Before you get the point of no return in terms of congeniality or whatever.
I may have reached congealness. I may have reached that already.
Congelity. Gelatinity.
Congelousness.
Yes.
Now, but is it going to still firm up?
See, yeah, I don't know. In fact, that's the thing I don't understand. Is like, it doesn't tell you. Well, it probably does tell people who can read it how long you're supposed to like wait for all this stuff to do its thing. But
also,
yeah,
these kits are old, so we don't know. They're old. We don't
know like us. They're old.
but so see, I do have a little green broccoli in there. You can see that.
Yeah.
So. Cool. On to the next thing.
Yeah, next is orange or yellow. It looks like orange since there's no yellow packet.
Orange. And
that is one
orange.
Which means one thing of water, right?
Right.
So that goes where? That goes in the...
The long slot?
No, which one? There's two oranges. There's an orange and then there's a redder one.
I would say it's the orange.
Oh, the red is next. No, wait, that's right. Pink is next.
Orange.
Pink is next.
Is next, right?
So, see, I'm seeing two of these.
No. See, red's at the bottom here. Let's not get confused. They do
so
match.
That's red.
The color does match.
And you get two there. And that makes sense because it's one is a smaller packet.
Yeah,
okay.
just match the
color. So
colors.
This goes in what?
What slot?
That's yeah, what mold? Let me see. It goes in...
That's hard to see. It is very hard to see which of these fucking things... And it goes in. Oh my god.
Wait.
Can you tell?
I cannot tell. Well, I'm already looking at this. Oh no.
Did we mess up?
We did. We're supposed to put the broccoli. It looks like the broccoli was supposed to be in here, wasn't it?
No. I think the broccoli's, yeah, broccoli's
no, you're right,
in the
right.
Spot.
We're in the right place. So,
which slot?
It looks like it's this one.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, here if you look.
Oh, okay. So we must build up layers of something then, right?
Yeah, apparently. Well, there's something that goes in here, but that seems to have skipped. So if you look carefully.
Okay.
It looks to me like, yeah, the orange goes in here.
Oh, right, because that's part of sushi.
Right, okay.
Okay.
Thank you all for bearing with us in our, you know, attempt to
play along. Get Popin Cookin and play along.
Truly. This isn't our first go-around with Popin Cookin, right? This is what? This may be my second. This is your what?
Oh.
You've got more Popin Cookin experience than I do.
Right. That just sounds funny to say.
It does.
You've got more Popin Cookin experience.
That's why I said it.
Well,
this is what we talk about while we're doing it.
All right. Yeah, this goes in the sushi tray, so to speak.
So we just pour the water. God, I feel like I'm like six. This feels like kindergarten, doesn't it? Oh, I'm using the thing wrong. You're supposed to use it so that it. Pours out
right,
slot.
Right. So I'm gonna get some water
okay.
myself,
and then
and
I guess you just mix it,
put
mix
it in my sushi slot.
That's right, because this thing you actually make in layers, right?
Yes, that's what was throwing us off.
Yes, yeah, the inability to read that it tells you you're doing this in layers.
All right.
Well, I mean, isn't it true that there are all these lots of shows on Japanese television showing Yankee people doing humiliating things, and the Japanese just love it?
Yes.
So we're just doing our little bit to add to that genre.
Well, there are a lot of, like I said, there are a lot of Popin Cookin channels that are probably presented a little cleaner than we do.
Oh, there's probably reality shows of experts, like America's Next Top Model versions of Popin Cookin,
But people, you know, I've seen one where a woman would make the stuff and then review it like a cooking show, review the flavor.
Well, you know, because I think we talked about ASMR in a previous Gay Nerd Love episode, and there are people who do Popin Cookin as ASMR.
Oh, sure.
Yes, so it's like a Venn diagram for people who both love Popin Cookin and get the ASMR effect where sound and visuals make you know, like kind of like get high.
This smells fruity too. It smells a little like pineapple.
Oh, it does.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm getting hungry already.
So, but it all just kind of looks sort of like a goo.
This is the joy of gelatin.
Oh my gosh, the joy of gelatin.
That would be the book that would write. So the next one is the pink.
And it's like, and are we supposed
the
to
pink
make,
goes in the little like.
Oh yeah, that little
that
character.
Little character. Yeah, exactly. It looks like a person or a. Sushi. It looks like a yabba dabba gabba goo.
So here, this is where we are so far, and now we're gonna do the pink.
Progress report. Yes, everything is powdered. And they're like, I'm sure there's like websites devoted to all the expert tips and tricks of this, right? But of course.
Oh, I don't.
At least we could use Google Translate.
I don't know that.
So we pour all the. You have to make sure you get all the powder in there. It's very important you not have any left over in the packet.
Maybe I'm masochistic, but I don't.
You enjoy the challenge, don't you?
I enjoy the challenge that I have no idea what the instructions mean. You know, it's not IKEA. Because IKEA is idiot-proof.
It really is. This is not idiot-proof. This is the opposite. This is like idiot-encouraging.
Idiot-enabler.
And idiot-enabling, that's what it is.
All right, so...
Or not idiot-enabling, let's just say language challenging.
Yes.
Non-linguistically challenging. So
you're right. This little thing does have a little pore spout so you can...
Yes, I keep forgetting to use it. Okay. So now we're supposed to mix this stuff so that it fully makes the most of the water and mixes the water with the...
You want to hold yours up?
I'm trying to, but...
Just for a variety?
Yes. See, I'm doing it. I'm making it work.
Yes.
You know,
I'm helping.
I'm helping. One thing we didn't bring was napkins, did we?
No. I wonder how...
What is... Okay, yeah. So what part of the thing are we making now, since I know nothing about sushi, since I don't eat that stuff?
I'm just going by the picture. So
yeah, what's that picture supposed to be a picture
we're
of?
Making sushi.
Is that the salmon or something?
We're making the salmon, yeah, the raw salmon.
Is that what that is? Okay, well, fortunately, it does not smell like raw salmon. Oh, God, that smells really good.
Ooh.
Oh, mm-hmm. I'm getting that candy store smell now.
They all have
a fruity candy store smell.
Fruity candy store.
Candy store smell is now my new punk band name.
Okay,
so then you notice that then the little bear appears. The
panda?
The panda bear appears. So this isn't just a mascot. We are actually going to try and create this creature. As part of the food.
Good luck.
So this is going to get interesting.
Again, these kids.
If it wasn't already.
These kids are old.
Well, yeah. See,
so we're hoping that they firm
up.
This
is the little panda area right here.
They're not firming up yet.
This is the panda area right here with like the little face.
Either way, however it comes out, I'm going to use this little fork to eat it.
That's the idea. That's the nice thing. What I love about this is that you make it and then you eat it.
Yes.
You know? Which is, I guess, what cooking's
all
about.
Hard work.
I don't cook. So I guess, to me, the idea of making something and then eating it is really strange and wonderful and unusual. Whereas most people cook go like, yeah, that's what you do when you cook. So it's like a new experience to me. Okay. So see, it looks like what we have to do is make the little monster, the little panda, and then like dye it with the...
Oh, right.
This is going to get really interesting.
All right, so now we're at blue.
We're at blue. Right. We've gone from green to yellow to pink, and now we're at blue.
Right here. You can't really, I don't think you can see that.
Yes.
It's better, because it's so tiny, it's better to just describe it. right. where we are. So we're now at blue, which I'm guessing is the large. Looks like the large section of the compartment, right here, and it says use two of the larger yes. blue packet. Use two waters to this large.
Now,
blue
where do
packet.
We mix it? I'm assuming we mix it in here, right?
That's what I was just, that's what I was just pointing us. Out. Yeah, the large container, the large does compartment is where it goes.
Yeah. So. What I'll do is I'm going to scan or take a picture of the back of the box.
Right.
And we'll post it on our Facebook, Instagram, whatever pages, Twitter. And then you can, follow along on that. So, yes. So, cutting the top off.
I'm going to see if I can get a sound out of the powder.
Oh, I'll be quiet. Okay. And if that didn't work, I'm going to try mine.
Okay. It's not granular. If it were granular, it would make more of a noise against the plastic, but it's just a powder.
Okay, be quiet. Okay. Oh, I like that sound.
Mm-hmm.
That's a soothing sound. Okay, and I'm getting ASMR now. So.
Now it's two waters for this compartment.
Okay, do you want to go first?
Yeah, I'll go first.
Meanwhile, I'm going to get my stuff together here.
A scoop?
Yes.
And see if I can throw it to the camera so you can actually... It's important to see the water go in?
Oh, it's important to see everything possible, yes. So what we're making now is the white, putty or whatever.
I think we're making rice.
Yes, this is the panda putty, or the putty to make the rice panda.
Yes.
Oh, you know, these, because of the way they trim, I think they're left-handed. Because the scoop here, there's more to grab on this side.
Are there a lot of left-handed people in Japan?
I don't know. That's a good question. I'm going to look that up.
And now I'm making rice.
Yes. I've heard that the same percentage of gay people and left-handed people are about,
ooh, that smells good.
About the same. Oh. What fruity smell is that? It should be like coconut, I think. Oh, yeah, there's, you notice that there's less water
yes.
per powder here, because what you're actually going to be doing here is making something that's much closer to like a silly putty than
very
it is.
Very firm, yeah.
Oh, it's looking like rice, though, isn't it?
Yes.
It's got kind of a rice consistency.
It does.
It's getting all fluffy. It's got the consistency of like really fluffy rice.
Now I know I said that these kits are old more than once, but a question just popped into my head is there a shelf life
on these?
There's no shelf life for candy. I thought there.
Well,
there, really?
There probably is, but I don't.
I mean, for stuff that's like sugar based, like this
stuff that's powder based, I don't think there's much as much of a shelf life, as long as it's not. The thing about these packets,
right,
these probably aren't going to get any moisture in them for years, unless
oh yeah
happens.
You can see the rice,
the texture's getting really really good here. Yes. See, it's getting this,
it's
kind
getting
of,
fluffy as you
yes
said.
It's, you know what, it looks like candy snow.
That's my hooker name
is Candy Snow.
Candy Snow
with a K.
Candy, are you out here again,
girl? Candy Snow, look at her, she thinks it's Christmas.
And them hooker boots,
you know, last year's hooker boots.
But she can't afford the newest ones.
No. She gets discounts. You know what, I hear Candy Snow gives coupons.
Okay,
so yes, now we're making little ride. Candy clouds.
Clouds of candy, right?
Clouds of candy, right? Yeah, but see, what we're going to be doing is shaping this now, right?
To look like a panda.
Yes.
All right. I have to still mix mine because I think I want to get all the powder mixed.
You do. In fact, that's what's interesting. You'll notice that when you first start mixing, it's like, oh, but there's still powder and it's not using the water. And then you just keep mixing and it just keeps like picking up powder.
It does.
It's kind of magical. So it is kind of like sea monkeys.
You don't want to eat those. Well, I guess you could.
No, you could eat them, but I wouldn't recommend it.
All right. I think I got all my powder.
Yes, you and the 1980s.
All right.
Okay.
All right. Candy rice is ready.
Oh, it smells like bubble gum.
It does.
It smells like bubble gum. It smells like Bazooka Joe. I just had a memory of being young and opening like a Bazooka Joe bubble gum wrapper.
Oh, sure.
It's very tact. You know that, you know, it's our sense of smell is our oldest sense.
Oh, I think I remember you saying that.
It's true.
Oh, and we're supposed to make panda balls.
Yeah, you mean panda spheres. Don't say panda balls. That's a different Popin Cookin.
The next stage.
And is there Popin Cookin porn?
If we do it on this packaging.
I'll bet there is.
Because this is actually our display tray and our where we shape the food.
Oh, yeah. So this is where real estate is a luxury or, you know, whatever. You have to make the most of everything.
They provide everything but the water.
You know, I just realized, you could do this on a serving tray on an airline. You could literally do this while you're on a plane.
And that would make it the time pass.
Exactly. We should take one of these with us
right
to Vegas and do it on the plane. And people wonder what the hell. They'll probably think we're making a bomb.
So the next thing we're supposed to do is to take this and shape it into one big ball, two little balls for the ears, and then some sort of lump. To the side, if you see that.
Is that like the body?
Oh.
Yeah. See, this is what we're doing now. The let's see, let's let it focus in.
Yeah, I think it's better to just show the other side.
Yeah.
We're doing
this is where the instructions that mean nothing to us are, and what we're doing
is we're making
creating
that with the ears and this thing here.
What is that?
I think it's supposed to be just rice with seaweed on it or
panda
something.
Body, I guess.
Panda body.
The head's been removed from the panda.
All right.
So why would this seem? This confuses me.
So now I'm going to.
Now it feels like Play-Doh, doesn't it? It feels like wet Play-Doh, only it smells better. I'll bet you could get kids to play with Play-Doh more if it smelled like bubblegum.
When kids would start eating it, though.
Play-Doh. Well, they do anyway.
But I mean,
I think we should just give kids these kids. See, now the problem is I'm worried about grabbing too much.
Well, I'm sure they provide you just enough. You know,
For each piece.
Well, I'm going to.
You're just taking the whole damn thing, aren't you?
I would just follow the picture.
It's what I'm trying to do. But the picture is the actual measurement of this is about half a centimeter. Not a lot of picture here. You're right. Basically, I should take all of this out here and just palm it. And oh, see, it's not working like that. There, yeah. Just rolling it into like that. You're doing better than I am. You're ahead of me.
It's not a race.
I know.
But okay. So going by the picture,
I don't think I used enough water.
Going by the picture, this is my panda head.
I'm gonna put this back in here and put some more water because I didn't get enough water there. Because I'm getting like all kinds of like fragmentation.
And I'm gonna make the ears of the panda, right? Yes. I think this piece needs to be a little smaller.
Okay. Hopefully, I'm just going by the ruin everything by putting too much water.
Oh no! It all ended in tears.
Don't touch it. It's concentrated evil.
Okay.
Now, we should do these more often and we get better at it.
Yeah, it's fun.
These are fun.
Oh, now my hands are sticky. Fuck it.
Yep, I told you. Next time, napkins.
Sugar. Sugar hands.
Sugar hands. That's my first album.
All right. Now, there are my panda
ears.
Now,
I seem to have made one rice ball.
Sure.
So now I just separate one out from it and make the separate little ears and face, right? Is that how you're doing it?
Yeah.
It's like it's very Disney-esque. I'm surprised they haven't sued.
So there are my panda.
Your panda things?
There's my panda head.
Your panda rice.
Panda rice and the little rice lump that goes on the box.
You're so much better at this than I am.
So it's supposed to look like panda. And then
as any child of America knows, you learn really quickly the difference between the picture on the box and what you're going to end up with.
Oh, so many children have been disappointed by that.
So many.
Oh, you know what? Although we don't have napkins, which we forgot next time, if you just let your hands dry for a minute,
then it
evaporates.
Right.
So
that's the beauty of this. They really, everything you need.
I'll wait. I'll wait for you, and I'll look ahead.
Don't
to see
wait
what,
for me.
No, look
just
ahead.
Plan ahead.
Just plan ahead. Card, to save yourself.
Yes.
So, right. So the next packet is gray.
I didn't make the bigger ball big enough. I need to make that so the smaller balls are small enough.
The next packet is gray, and gray makes the dark...
That makes the ink...
The ink for...
For the face.
For the face.
They actually made this little... And the ears. This little, the little part of the... If you want to show them, the little part of the kit where you actually put the ink in is like a little... like a stencil in reverse. It's this little thing right there.
Oh, right. Yes.
If you want to show them that.
Yes, the ink goes in here.
I think my panda is going to be a mutant panda with one ear that is slightly smaller than the other.
I'm very interested to see how this all comes together.
Well, that's true.
But I'm going to go ahead and start my ink.
Start your ink. Okay. Go on. Go without me. Go ahead.
The ink goes in two places. The ink goes in three places. Oh, how do you do that? You separate it out to three places. How does one do that?
Well, I think what you do... If I'm seeing it correctly, is I believe you put a little bit of the powder in here and the rest of it in here.
Okay.
That's what I'll bet you do.
So the ink has to go here, here, and here.
Here and here.
And the way to do that, you're right, put a little powder first and then just...
Put a little powder
because
there.
Because it does not... Oh, does it say how to...
It does not explain in a language that we can discern.
All right, fine. Fine.
So that's okay, but that's okay.
I'm gonna go crazy.
Yes, Sandra. You're right. All you do is you wait long enough. It's like Elmer's glue. It just dries and then you can just kind of rub and flake it off. So. Okay. So it's so gray and it says three, right?
Three what?
This number three there is that, but I don't think that means three waters.
That does not mean three
waters. Oh, it's steps. Look, one. It's right. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's Oh, okay. Good thing I didn't put three. My ink would have been all like diluted.
Right. So the next step is.
Oh, look! It's all like I didn't crunch mine up first. Make sure that you crunch it up good because I didn't do that.
You have to crunch up the ink. Is it? I wonder. That's interesting.
Maybe because of the oldness.
Or it's maybe
the crystals are probably congealing.
Well, the ink is probably a different crystal from the rice,
yeah,
right?
It probably is. It's true. So it goes. So what, you put a little bit.
Oh, this will be fun.
Oh, Jesus. Put a little in there.
This is like total eyeballing. Oh, do you see the little arrows inside that tell you?
Yes. I do. Now we do.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah.
Oh, this. Okay.
This looks like really small sen-sen. Remember sen-sen?
No, is that what is that?
It was
is that a mint?
It was a breath mint kind of stuff.
Oh right, okay, and so like in the Billy Joel song.
If you get too much, well, that is if there isn't water right there, you can just brush it into that.
Oh, I see.
Like that. You know, this reminds me. It reminds me of that metallic shavings kit. You could like make the little beards.
I used to love those.
Yeah.
Yes, it came with the bar magnet inside, right? In the face. I think that's still around.
It is. I think you can get it at, like, novelty toy shops and stuff like that.
Now, this is totally guesswork, because how much ink do you know to put in the larger pieces?
Well, I think... Oh, no. Wait a minute. Well, see, the arrows indicate that you would put this in there, but I think it's the other way around. I think what they mean is what we're probably supposed to be doing... is making it in here and then dumping it in there.
Oh.
I like my idea better, though, don't you?
I like making it in the face.
I like making it in the face, but then we're not supposed to talk about that. I'm going to try that. I'm going to go with my idea.
I like your idea better, yeah.
Yeah, see, we're kit bashing already. Okay.
Make it in the face, and then you transfer it to... I see. And then you make a ball of ink, and then you transfer it to the other
two
containers.
The arrow should be the opposite direction, but then maybe it's an American thing. Okay, so then I put the rest of my ink in here, I guess?
Right, and then you make an ink ball, it would seem. Well, I wonder about that. I don't know if that's right, because the next picture shows...
We don't have to do... We
shows
don't have
you
to
putting
follow
your rice... inside of these compartments. So
yes, here's the thing. I think that you're just supposed to dye it with the face instead of making the face, like whatever. Because now I'm going to have to basically eyedropper water into the face, and I don't think that's going to work very well. But
we'll see.
We'll find out. So I'm first of all, I'm going to put the water in. How many? It doesn't say how many. I'm going to assume one. But then I'm going to just put a little bit of water in there.
Oh.
Because I think it's only supposed to be ink. I don't think it's supposed to be like the congeal stuff.
Ink, you're right. Right.
So I'm just going to put the ink.
So I'll do the same. Mm-hmm. While you're doing it, you
should be doing it the right way and let me do it the wrong way, but
There is no right or wrong.
There is no right or wrong. It's true. No one's being judged.
It's just ink.
It's just ink, baby.
All right.
Oh, it's like his face is all wet now. So I'm just kind of spreading the water here and hoping it just doesn't become a complete and utter mess.
I put a lot of water in
Yeah,
his
I did
face.
The same thing. Yeah, in fact, it's like I wished I had a little Kleenex or something to just...
Oh, we're going to go grab a paper towel? Okay,
No, I'm going to grab some Kleenex I have right here.
All right.
So we're cheating officially.
No, we're not cheating.
Yes.
So
I think it's cheating if you use anything other than the kits.
Well, I'm gonna mix up.
Actually,
my ink
technically, you don't even need scissors. You could probably tear them with your teeth. So you really don't need anything else other than.
You know, the ink is not the consistency is not entirely liquid.
Is it actually kind of a gunk?
It's kind of gooey.
I will bring in some non-branded tissue. Because we don't have any sponsors here. We aren't even sponsored by Popin Cookin.
No.
No, we're doing this out of the kindness of and enjoyment of our heart.
Interest. So I'm going to absorb the extra water on the face.
The water because I'm Messy Marvin.
All right.
That's kind of working, although it's kind of absorbing all of the ink that was in the face. So now I have to try and... You really need for this... is like an eyedropper.
Yes.
That would really help. I should get one from Scrap, because they have them at Scrap right now. Okay, so...
All right, well, okay.
Where's my... There it is. So I need to put more of...
How are we supposed to put that?
Maybe I did it right. We did it right, because I don't see how you're supposed to get that ink in there.
Right.
That doesn't make sense.
Ladies and germs, so we're blotting off the extra water.
Yes.
And
I blotted off the extra water.
And here we are in the kit. We have ink for dyeing our rice.
That's a sentence I never thought I'd hear anyone ever utter.
Ink for dyeing my rice?
Ink for dyeing my rice. It sounds like a euphemism.
Mark that.
Oh, see, I am taking some of the ink from here and putting it in here, so it is actually working the way it's supposed to
That's
work.
That's what I actually did it with a fork, but I knew it would have been easier.
Oh, you're smart.
No, I think it would have been easier with a napkin.
With the edge of this? Well, yeah. Yeah, kind of maybe.
But, all right, so
now we have our
there.
Mickey Mouse. See, mine looks more like Mickey Mouse than a panda.
And now we're supposed to dye the rice balls.
Not touching that.
We're on our way to, again...
Keep showing us what we're supposed to get to, I think that's the only place you're going to see it, but, okay.
So I'm going to try the rice ball with the strip.
I had two even rice balls instead of one smaller than the other, but, oh well.
You should think of Mickey Mouse's head.
That's what I did.
Oh.
So I guess you flatten it, kind of?
Yes.
So it's kind of a pillow rather than a sphere.
Yes.
So I kind of did that. And then I guess...
Flat, and you're supposed to put it on the strip, right? You're supposed to have an ink strip on it.
Huh?
Oh, you're doing the face. I'm doing the rice ball first, so...
Oh, fuck the rice ball.
Oh.
Oh, shit. I dropped it.
Oh.
my panda has acne. No, that didn't work out at all.
I wonder how long you're supposed to...
That did not work out at all. In fact,
it's just goo.
It just does not work.
It's just gray.
This part does not work. Yeah, it just ends up looking like a cotton ball that, like, dabbed some ink. Yeah, I knew this was going to be the most disappointing part of the entire endeavor.
No, fuck it. I'm going to use the fork and just...
Are you just going to paint one?
No, I'm painting it, yes.
Yes. Yeah. I'm going to do the same. I'm going to say, okay, if that's the hair, then I'm going to just...
Yeah, so yeah, that's my painted rice ball.
Painted rice ball, yes.
And now, well, the pandas are going to be supremely disappointing, I'll bet. You know, the only thing that'll come out good is the ears, because you can roll them around in here, which I think you're supposed to do, to make them black.
Yeah, that's what you're supposed to do, is just put them in there and let them soak it up. Yeah, this stuff doesn't, this ink stuff doesn't really work as well as you would think. It's not really a dye.
No.
It's just basically I don't think
it's us.
No, I think that's, yeah, I mean, look, see, it just kind of makes your finger, it's not ink.
Mm-mm.
But it's delicious.
Now look at that. That's supposed to be, that fucking thing is supposed to be an ear.
No. No. I'm going to have mine have one black ear and one white ear. So it's going to be heterochromatic.
Okay. And I'm going to try to make another ear.
So
yeah, it doesn't absorb right.
So I don't, maybe it put too much water in our.
No, that's not it.
Hmm.
You think so?
Too or maybe water? We diluted the consistency of the ink by spreading it out over the two.
That could be
it. That's probably what we did wrong. It's our fault, probably.
Yes. Is that the, oh shit, I just put some ink in my broccoli.
Well, I'm not going to tell anybody.
Okay, now I know the panda's face is gonna look like shit.
Good, because mine's a complete failure. I've given up on the panda face.
But I'm gonna try it anyway.
Good for you.
So
there you go.
What we have is this. Theoretically, it's supposed to look like the picture. And come on, does it ever look like the picture?
No, it doesn't.
I mean, even when you order fast food, it never looks like the picture.
No, I've given up on my panda here. My panda looks like he looks like someone whose face has been bashed in.
Okay, so I'm going to press this into the
panda
face. And I'm holding it there. And I know what I'm going to, I don't know.
Now,
I already know what I'm going to get.
Be careful, because when you lift up, it tends to stick and then drop. And so that's how I ruined mine. So if you bring it back. See? That's my point. The only way this was achieved was with paint and a paintbrush. I do not believe this was done with this kit. I'm sorry. I just don't.
No.
In fact, I think this little elephant right here is laughing at anybody who thinks that this is actually what it's going to look like.
I'm going to fucking dip the rice ball into the ink.
Totally.
What do you call it? A charcoal.
Yes.
Mouse face or whatever.
I am going to do the same. I'm just going all out here with, let's use up that, that goo.
Now I'll try to, you know, I will try to stick to the instructions for the others, but for now, this is just dirty snow.
Yep, that's what it is. Yep, I'm going to.
Same with the sushi, too. I'm going to do the same thing with the sushi.
Sushi shmushi.
I mean, I'm sorry, the rice.
The rice.
Dirty snow.
Ooh.
Dirty snowballs.
Look at what that looks like.
Oh.
Just looks really gross. It's got this moon of Jupiter like texture.
It does. Yeah, little really asteroids. Gross.
Yeah, like they're boogers. That's what these are. You know, that's what if they were to try and bring this to America, they would basically turn this into making for American kids. It would be make really gross food.
And I think those kits exist, and those American kits, you can make nasty
but
stuff.
Right, correct me if I'm wrong, this is not made for kids in Japan, is it? Grown-ups make these.
Oh, adults make
pretty
them.
Much? Grown-ups is make that them. Not correct?
I thought, yeah.
This is not like, oh, Barbie's Kitchen or something. This is a Japanese of the, phenomenon of adults.
Of the right? Popin Cookin assembly videos I've seen on YouTube, it's always adults doing them.
Exactly. So it's kind of a food fetish, I think. It's like it's like adults who build dollhouses.
Okay, so I'm moving on from that disappointment to this. I think that's supposed to be chicken. that brown thing right there is the next thing we're supposed to do. The brown packet.
Oh, see, I don't eat sushi, so I don't know what any of this shit is.
And from the.
So what do we do for
diagram,
that?
It seems to go into the large compartment again. See, Now, this is something I just...
The large compartment?
It's kind of surprising.
The one that's empty?
The one that we mix rice in is now empty because it absorbed most of the powder. And we used that compartment again to make this vaguely chicken-colored ball of something.
Yeah, and that's the brown, right?
Yeah, it's, I think it's supposed to be fried chicken.
It is.
A fried chicken ball. Get my skeezers.
Yep, crunch, 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 crunch. Hope this smells like chocolate, but it probably doesn't.
No. Oh, the ones. Oh, I mean, I think they have ones where you can like make fake ice cream. That sounds so good.
Oh yeah, I want to do that one of these days.
Right.
Maybe we'll get that for the Vegas trip.
Brown powder.
Can we buy these here in Portland, or do we have to order them?
Well, Portland does have them in Awajamaya, so I would imagine that they do have them there.
Okay.
But online you get more variety than you do in the store.
True.
That's my understanding. Okay, so that's the powder for the brown chicken ball.
Yes, and it says one water.
One water. Okay.
It says on there, it says one water. Yes.
Number one. All right. There's my scoop of water. And I'm pouring it into that.
Okay.
And now you see the brownish.
The kind of part of the magic is watching as the powder transforms. The minute water hits it, it immediately begins to like work its magic. See, you just put the water right in and then it immediately starts to do its thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The light's not in the right place.
Well, it's just, my shadow.
Yeah, I'm in your shadow. Yeah. I mean, everything is in kind of shadow. There. Yeah, it's already looking very...
Yeah.
See, it looks darker to me than the light makes it look.
Mm-hmm.
But it's... Yeah, it's actually this is one of the few things it's actually looking like in the consistency of what it's supposed to look like.
Mm-hmm.
But yes. And as usual, the less water makes it the more gummy. So that's why it's just one.
All right.
And then what you're supposed to do is what?
Shape it into a fried chicken ball, I think. What does that smell like?
It smells like gum.
Yep.
I think they use the same flavoring, coloring that gumballs do, because they smell like gumballs.
Or gummy?
Gumballs.
Oh, gumballs.
I'm smelling gumball. Gumball gumballs. Or gumball gum is what I'm trying to mutter.
All right. So, yeah, look, I mean, it kind of, you know, if you use your imagination, it sort of looks like fried chicken.
It looks like a chicken McNugget.
It does.
In a bizarre kind of way, but yeah.
Make sure I get all the powder off the sides.
So you're just supposed to shape it into a. Does it say what shape or?
On the bot, I just go by the picture.
Oh yeah, it just says basically a kind of like a chicken patty is what it shows that you're supposed to make.
You're supposed to make that thing right there. Okay, a chicken patty. All right.
Yeah, I remember her. So, and that just goes over here in the waiting area.
All right.
The rest of this cleaned out, because I know we're probably going to use this mixing bin again, aren't we?
Probably, yes.
For something.
Okay, well, we're almost done with this. Okay. Oh, no, okay, this is exciting.
The hardest part?
No, this is as much fun. Last time I made sushi, like in the picture,
really?
The icon.
Okay.
I'm going to cut to that just for a second, because in the older Gaynor Love episode, we did that sushi with the little eggs on top
mm-hmm.
of it and the seaweed wrap. That was a lot of fun, but this time we make noodles, and that's what the little plastic bag is for. It so we can make noodles. So I'm
squeeze them out.
Yes, candy noodles.
Oh, kind of like a pastry chef.
Candy noodles was her sister.
Candy noodles. Yeah, you know, She didn't meet a very good end, but yeah.
There's a okay. So how do does one do that?
Okay. Well, based on the picture, it looks like we mix it in the big bin.
Two waters.
Two waters, and then put it in the bag. I mean,
put her in a bra.
Then I guess they scoop it in the bag. Yeah, because if you put it in the... That's why there's two waters, is because it becomes real gummy if it's one water, but if it's two waters, it becomes more pasty.
Okay, but what is this? What is this?
That's the bag. I guess it's...
Oh.
I don't know what the first picture is. The second picture is... The first picture, I think, is the bag. And...
That's the bag?
Oh. I think so.
Okay. Do you mix it in the bag, or?
Yeah, it means get the bag, put it in the bag, and then you cut the little corner out. But don't cut the corner out until it's in the bag, obviously.
Oh.
And then you squeeze it and make the, like, spaghetti-like whatever noodles.
Well, it looks like you mix it in the tray.
You do mix it in the tray.
And then you put it in the bag.
Yes.
And then you squeeze it out.
Yes.
Okay.
So.
All right, cutting this. And we are going to definitely do, I like this sort of demonstration table idea, and we'll refine it in the future and do a lot of fun things with it.
We promise.
It's fun to us.
Yeah. Hey, nobody's forcing you to watch. When?
All right. There is the powder. The noodle powder.
True.
Now I have to say that they do get the texture right most of the time, because things that are supposed to be, they look like what they're supposed to be.
Yeah, on the box. Well, like I'll say you're right, because the chicken patty turned out pretty good.
Yes.
So now I'm.
It's two.
I'm mixing. Yes, it's two. Right,
so it's one.
Mix.
And two. All right.
Oh, this smells. This has a particularly powerful scent, doesn't it?
Mm, it does. It doesn't quite smell like gum. It smells like.
No, this smells more like candy.
Like candy. Like what do you call it? Like pixie sticks?
Yeah. This has pixie stick smell.
Or sweet tarts or something.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, look at that! Oh, look at that! It's turning into sort of like a
yes, it's like frosting.
Like a frosting.
Yeah, which is how it's going to be used when we put it in the bag, in the provided again bag, which even tells us wisely that we cut the corner to make this work.
Now, don't let our demonstration
put
you off of trying these Popin Cookin kits, because I think you'll have a lot of fun doing it.
I think that's the part of the fun, is that it's not perfect and easy, you know?
Oh, yeah, that's fine. Okay. So I think we're done with the water, done with all the packets.
I'll just put all this shit all over the side. Mm-hmm. Yep.
With my display tray up.
Okay.
So where we are now, as far as on the display tray, we have a dirty snowball panda, dirty snowball of rice, vague chicken patty, and
we haven't even got the vegetables. Fortunately, they're forming on their own. So the less they have to do with us, the better they're going to turn out.
All right. So we put it in the bag first. Is that what you said? And then cut it? Or?
Yes. Okay. Otherwise, you're going to be putting it in the bag and it's going to start using out.
That makes sense. So.
So I think just kind of scoop it with the fork. Yes.
I'm going to scoop it away from the other trays so that I don't accidentally.
Smart, because I'm a klutz and I need to do the same.
Oh, if you put your thumb on the fork, that'll slide it into there better.
Yeah. That makes sense. So we just put the goop in there.
Goop. Noodle goop.
Noodle goop.
No, Gwyneth Paltrow's website.
It is. Noodle Goop. Actually, Noodle Goop is an offshoot.
For the Asian market.
For the Asian. I was just going to say that. Come here. Okay. So, yeah, I'm getting my bag of noodle paste.
Noodle paste. That's what
noodle
it really
paste
is.
Sounds like some astronaut food, doesn't it?
Oh, I wonder, is astronaut food powdered, or is it just like in the yep. Martian, in those little...
I think it's powdered. Oh. I think the whole idea is they send everything up powdered, and then they just reuse the water, and I mean they reuse the water.
Reuse all the water, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, so now we're moving it to one corner of the bag, right?
Well, so I think that's a wise idea, yes. I am ending up in the other corner, but... I don't think it matters which corner it comes out. Okay, right, mistake to put your finger in the bag.
So that's the noodle goop.
Yep.
And one of us definitely has to be closer to the camera to show the magic of it oozing out, right?
Well, I nominate you because you're more better at this. This is the stuff. It's looking like pumpkin paste.
And I would say that... This makes sense, right? The width of the hole determines the width of your noodle.
Not going to touch it. Not going to touch it.
Got my scissors.
Notice, when I packed mine into the corner, mm-hmm. I left a little air bubble.
Oh, yeah.
So it didn't immediately start oozing out.
Oh, yes. So I'm going to now attempt to...
Go for it. I'm going to stop and watch and learn from the master.
All right.
Okay.
I cut a little corner.
And then what do you pour it onto here? I'm going to hold onto this while you...
Oh, while you find out what we squeeze it onto?
Yes.
It does not say...
I think you just pour it on the damn thing.
No, let me look. Huh. That's interesting. Doesn't really say.
No.
Oh, well, I think you're supposed to make a bento box out of
you
this
are.
Thing.
Yes.
I'm not going to bother with
no.
that.
No, we're too old.
Yeah, that's a little much.
Okay.
So, but how does it all come together?
You just arrange it.
You just arrange it. Okay, so you just make a little, I'm just going to squeeze a little pile of noodles, so to speak.
Yep.
Into here.
I was going to hold it up so it would be near the camera.
Oh, you're going to do that? Okay.
So that you hold, I hold this and you squeeze those.
Oh, I made them too thick.
Well, squeeze hard.
No, I'm going to go the other end. Oh. See if I can squeeze it out of the other end. Mmm. Yes, my noodles would come out too thick because I cut the corner too thick. So.
Oh, you mean too wide?
Too wide.
Okay. Yes. So your noodles would be too large. They would end up being like noodle sausages.
Yes. All right, I made a much thinner cut.
Okay.
And the other opposite
okay.
end. Now I'm going
like
to...
Like a teeny little one.
They're still thick.
Yep. Oh, well. Yep. All I can think of now is fuzzy pumper Play-Doh stuff. It's kind of orange soft serve ice cream, but... Hey... noodly. Oh, there you got one that's really small. Okay. And show.
As soon as I get the last out, I want all the noodles.
The completest you.
Get okay. that noodle out of there.
Oh, there you go. Yes, you ended with a flourish of... Smaller
now, noodles. Now, jiggle the tray to see that they actually sort of kind of move.
Hello, I'm the noodles. All right.
What time do you have to be at work?
ASAP.
Okay.
Probably by noon.
By noon?
My last day.
Oh, well, we got to end then.
Okay, so I cut a really tiny little one.
It's like 20 minutes till.
I know.
Okay. Look at those noodles.
Okay.
All right.
So
I think the noodles came out the best, really, as far as resembling the picture.
I think you're right. But then we get to do what? Peel all the stuff out?
Assemble everything. It's good luck.
Okay. So how did you do it? Did you just do it this way? Just put everything?
Can you not do that?
Well, I can't do that and talk, but I'll do it left-handed, even though I'm not left-handed. Because who cares?
Your noodles are thinner.
Yep.
I had to use both
hands. I learned from your lesson.
Oh, good.
But, see, I can't. All this stuff is...
I had to use both hands for...
Right. I'm trying to do that and stay near the mic.
So you're squeezing out your noodles. They're coming out thinner than mine. They're more noodle-like.
I can't. Sit it down.
Okay, I'll
set it down.
We had one demo with mine. So, and now we're supposed to arrange...
Talk and distract them from my inadequate noodles.
Arrange an inadequate noodle. It's sad to have an inadequate noodle.
Well, I wouldn't know. But.
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong with your noodle, baby.
Hey. TMI.
Where are we now with this? So, if we were to go through the trouble of making this into a bento box,
it would
look something like this. But we're going to skip all that and just arrange them on this handy-dandy tray here.
Our quickie tray.
Quickie tray.
So to go.
So now, somehow we're supposed to scoop these things out of here.
I think you're supposed to pop them out, kind of like an ice cube, aren't you?
They're supposed to pop out, and I think that...
Well, see, I think the reason is they have you do the gooey stuff or the gummy stuff first so that it has time to harden.
Right, and now we're really just going to test if it's hard enough.
Not going to touch that one.
Okay, hey, you know what? It did. At least one of them did.
Oh, look, my noodles actually turned out pretty good.
Yeah. The yellow thing...
Everything else is a disaster, but I think my noodles look pretty good.
The yellow thing has a texture. It came out...
Now, what do you do with that? Do you roll it?
Who the fuck knows? it's supposed to look like that. And it kind of does.
Yeah, if you blur your vision.
There's the yellow thing there.
It's a bit washed out, but you can get it, the idea.
There's the yellow thing there.
So do you just use the bottom of the fork to kind of start it?
Just scoop it out, yes. Scoop it out in one direction. And now I'm going to...
Oh, no. See, now mine, I use too much water.
I'm going to try to get out the my vegetable that's dyed with ink and see. Yeah, I think I used too much...
Your poisoned vegetable.
I think I used too much...
Yeah, I used too much water on my stuff.
Okay, my vegetable's just kind of a lump of green. It's just like...
Yeah, mine too.
Alien mucus.
Mine too. Mine looks like a mutant dot. Like the candy you get for the... Oh, yeah, like it's...
All right, so there's that green thing.
Tastes good, though.
And that's supposed to look like... It's supposed to look like that.
Basically, this is a lesson in disappointment between what you... Oh, hey, but this turned out really good.
The sushi?
My sushi turned out good, actually. It's so good, I can't even get a handle on it. It's slippery and slimy. Just like real sushi.
My sushi did, too.
I think that's the stuff that we use the least water on.
Right. So,
in
the future, be careful with your measurements.
I kept thinking that you needed to, like, that one needed to, like, make sure that it was a full part of this, but I think actually it's not. I think you just scoop it out and the amount of scoop of water.
See, look how well the piece of sushi came out. That looks really good.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, my sushi came out pretty good. Yeah, that's not so good. That came out much better. It's firmer. So that. And then we're supposed to eat this stuff, right?
Yes.
That's the best part.
There we go. There is my tray
of stuff.
Of sad.
my tray of sad. Edible sad. That's what we should have named this episode.
It's supposed to look like that. And this is how it looks.
Tray of edible sad from Archie and Andy. Sad.
But we are going to eat it. And Andy has to get it going. So let's, that's the Popin Cookin, our bento box kit.
Yes.
So at the end of the show, please subscribe to our, if we haven't driven
Believe
you
it
are,
or not, regardless of what you've just seen, YouTube please subscribe channel. To our YouTube channel.
At the end of the show, we're going to run all of our social media presences where you can find this and past episodes of Gaynard Love and other projects by Bad Maria Productions.
Yeah, we encourage you to follow us, not just so you can read what we're doing or to see the stuff that we post, but to post back and to... comment and add and, you know, give us ideas for things you'd like to see or things that you've done.
And
pictures of your Popin Cookin successes or whatever.
And tell your friends.
Tell your friends to listen in, to subscribe, to follow us.
So until next time, I gaynard love you, Andy.
I deliciously gaynard love you, Archie.
A project of Bad Maria Productions.
We really don't have to do this.